Hey everyone, and welcome back to episode 432 of Fallout 4. Last episode, just look at it, man. All of these turrets.
You showed up just in the nick of time.
I've got a nice way up into the base. I'm starving. I'm thirsty. I'm tired, but it's all for the sake of extra XP. In fact, stop. No, wrong buttons. Make sure I quick save, just in case. Put down Vault Grill. Hey, Vault Grill. Nice blanks there. Hey, Vault Boy. Nice blanks there, man. They got lights. They got pictures of kitty cats in here. They got the whole shebang. They even have a rug. So that's my room for my followers, my settlers, my whatevers. I put generators up top, and the game was all like, "Yo, dog, you can't put anything else in the settlement. Like, stop." And I'm all like, "Want to bet?" So let's pop a quick save just in case things go wrong. And we're going to do the good old settlement size glitch because it is a very, very needed, necessary part of. I don't need to take the mollies out. Stop taking the mollies out. It is a very necessary. I wonder, actually, if having the mollies being 7 items would make messing with settlement size easier. But anyway, I need to increase the amount of size allowed to be added to the settlement. So let's cheese it, basically. 10mm rifles. Anything that's not mine or equipped or that I'm using needs to be dropped. You can see all the items just piling up in the corner right there. Missile launchers, all these mollies. I don't know if basically storing a stack of 7 would be quicker than doing 7 individual ones. I bet it would stack and I bet it would make sense. But let's find out. I do need to take everything I find. Nothing more can be built. What a bet? What are you doing? I didn't even press that button. I pressed R. Alright, yeah, I'm just storing. Oh, actually, I was scrapping all those things. Oopsie daisies. That's okay. Most of that stuff is garbage anyway. But what I want to do mainly is store it like this, because it's still, as you can see, bringing my settlement size down, and that's all we need. Store the pipe pistol, store all these, store those, and those, and I don't see anything else. Oh, board. It kind of blends in the pile really well. Anything else fly off in the distant? Oh, knuckles. There's things that are really hard to see, like knuckles. Things that are really hard to see and easy to miss. Pipe bolt action pistol, knife. Yeah, things that go in that little loot pile, I can't really see, but there you go. You see settlement size just increased quite a bit. That's all we need. That's all I want.
Now
I
can go for your help, pal.
Shh, guys, we killed the super mutants forever ago. It's been days, and they keep thanking me for the super mutants. The defense from the super mutants. Floor, shack, up. Once more, let's go fix that boo-boo god right here. Boo-boo? Boo-boo, please. Yes! Okay, boo-boo be fixed, and I did want to slap down an extra generator. Power generators, the gigantic one is what we're working with. Okay, now the gigantic one. I should look into this. What am I doing? Oh, let's stop and think here. That's 100 power. Truly, though, I don't think we have a need for it. And what I mean is, so what, we have 2 power being needed per each one of those turrets, right? Let me jump over here. I didn't mean to do that. So we have 1, 2, so okay, so let's do it this way. 2, 4, 6, 8, who do we appreciate? No, 10, I'm not a cheerleader. 12, 14, 16, 18, oh, I forgot to put one there. And it should be a laser, hold on. So essentially, that's 100 power. That would be great, but I don't think it's really needed. I think based off the big generators we have, that's more than enough. There's no real point. Because that one is actually something that commits resources. The other ones are basically free. But that one also really works well if you have a huge setup that requires a lot of power. Because that's 100 power in a single, like a single thing. Not like a single tile, but like a single item. This one to me is stupid. I don't understand. Can anybody explain the purpose of this? Generator, windmill, cool, natural energy, you know, like renewable. I get it. Three power for something this size when this is free and does 3? I don't understand the purpose of that one in all seriousness. But these ones, we're going to go with these ones for now. Everything should all be linked up. This all this power should be daisy chained and ready to go. I would like one more wall here. Wood, wall, at least one more anyway. can't see. Get all the way over and block that off. Now, the power I'll probably make go up and over. And then it'll go down this wall through here, through that. I could probably just get rid of this generator too. So let's get our conduits going. Let's make this something. Power pylon. Oh, I could put a pylon here and bring the power down. That'd be easy. Or maybe. I thought it made it come off the top, but it doesn't. So what I gotta do is squeeze a power conduit, like right up top, if it'll let me. And if it doesn't, I'll have to do something different. Something along these lines. So, how high up can I get one of you? I don't know how well this is gonna work. Shit. Can I not really go up and over with these walls? Damn. I can go around, but that's not really what I wanted to do. But if it's what I have to do, well then, I have to do it. Like, this one, see how it, like, kind of rounds off the edge there? Oh, like, there. Like, I kind of wish I did that on the on the top, but it doesn't. I can't just put one flat on the edge, so that's gonna have to be different. It's not gonna be what I want, but welcome to the real world where you get a whole lot of I don't want, but I have to put up with. really don't want to like put two here, but well, if it works, it works. And then you to that. Awesome. So this thing effectively has all of my power. And then this is no longer necessary. But it also looks like butt. So, let's put conduit here. Can I do this? Awesome. You don't need to exist. You can be stored. You can go... you're a bit in the way. So let's put you off to the side. Go there. And I can put a conduit down here. Power conduit. Oh, there's some more idiot savant. There's some more extra, I got some extra XP. And see if we can just get this power delivered to where we want it. And now, does this reach? Oh yeah, that reaches. Yes! That's good news. I don't have to keep putting conduits down there. So I can just daisy chain these bad boys. As long as it lets me. Cool. Cool. Look at the defense. Oh my god, 336 and we're barely even started. Holy shit. And we'll know if we need more power if it goes red. And then there's up above and beyond the amount of power that we'll require up there, but it was for Shenane's sake, if nothing else. 456. 400. 400! Guys, 456. I could even bring power up top, a conduit, bring it along the outside edge, and bring it to these pumps. You know? I could do that. And I might, but I'll probably do some rearranging down here. There's nothing that's going to get through here. There can't be anything that gets through here. I want a settlement attack to happen now. I want to see what happens. I want to see whatever it is get destroyed. Alright, now we gotta do some more practical things. Like get some crafting stations down and get the food situation figured out. So I think I have zero worries, zero concerns now about putting farms in here. I could put them on the outside, but if I put them in here, they're even more heavily defended. This is assuming the game lets me do it, because this terrain is very awful to build with. I've explained that. That's why we're building in the sky. But it's also like, oh, can I not interact with this because you're there or something? Well, let me store you. There you go. It's got a lot of like rocks in it, and sometimes I can't put my crops down. So we have a bunch of people working on crops here, but that's obviously not, I don't know, like the greatest spot for this. At least I don't think it is. Can I store this? Yeah, it seems to be whenever they interact with it, you can't manipulate it until they're finished. Like that person is working on it, and I can't. Store, please. Store. That was weird. It isn't letting me manipulate it whenever I want to. Whatever. Food. Mute fruit. These guys need food. They're starving. And I also need mute fruit for many things. So we'll start right here. Just do a big old line of mute fruit. Works for me. Corn and potatoes, obviously stuff that I like, but for one reason or another, mute fruit seems to be the biggest limiting factor. And then I'll need to assign people to jobs like vendors and stuff. Because not only will that produce happiness, which I don't really care about, because it doesn't do too much to your... I know it sounds cruel, but it doesn't really do anything to your settlement, at least in my experience or my understanding. It's not an essential. It's not food or water. But I'd rather have some vendors doing their thing so I have people to sell to, and, well, that's just better for me. Because we don't make these settlements... It's funny. I mean, we don't make these settlements to be settlers. We just do it for my benefit, and they don't know any better. They have no idea what's going on. Okay, I just want to make these meet up. Good enough. That should be more than enough food. You, food okay. Jobs. That sounds lewd. I want a food job. Sure. You, here. Everybody, get on the food train. I mean, it's one value per. They can only do six. There's quite a few mute fruit there, so this should hopefully give me a lot of jobs. You... doesn't really matter who I assign to it, just as long as those people come over here. If it's unassigned, we'll assign it. So we are at 25, we should go to 31. 31. So there's still more food available, is what that's telling me. I wonder why we're only at 31, and we're assigning people to food that have one value. Unless... we finally did. Okay, it looks like all of it's assigned. Now I could add more crops, but let's make sure we get these shops down and there's still people left over to run them. That should be my next thing. Shops and crafting stations. Wouldn't be a bad idea to put the shops back here. So stores, trader, a general trader does not hurt. I like general traders because they sell me materials and stuff. Put you here, and I want to try to line some of these shops up. Weapons dealer, obviously always one of my biggest. And this is going to cost me quite a few caps, but it's totes worth. Food and drink, not necessary. Clinic, well, I don't mind it. Food and drinks is kind of dumb. Why you do snap? Good. See, now if I go over here, their back's going to be exposed to potential fire, but... there's nothing really that's ever going to come that way, so, Clothing store, not something I particularly need, but having more shops because of, like, the resource pool, the better. So let's do that. Alright, so that you know, chews into my cap supply a bit, but I think it's worth it. Come on, crafting interface, and let's start grabbing people to work. You. Oh, I got it closer. You.
Got it.
Do things. You. That guy's like half naked. You know, you're half naked. You can be our doctor. That sounds hot. You. One of a few people who actually has clothes on. You can be the weapons person.
Sure.
And select. Oh, I can't do it that well. I was like, can I just select that and then tell a person to do this and have my trips? But no. So I'm hoping these people figure out how to path up here. I don't have the utmost faith in them, but we know quick saving and, or sleeping and stuff does the trick. Awesome. So we have all of our vendors that I really would ever need. Crafting stations are something that I personally need myself, so screw them. And I still want to put like maybe a shotgun turret just kind of looking right here, or a handful of turrets or something. Some extra form of defense just in case something gets up there. Chem station... cooking station. I like the cooking stove the best. It's small, compact. It probably looks the best, I think. Power armor station would be needed, but not yet. Anyhow, I can't get the cooking station closer to the wall because of like how it protrudes like that. But it is what it is. I don't need those. So power armor station is the only thing that's missing from this area. We can spread out the stations a bit. Doesn't have to be so cramped. We have the room. Cool. Power armor crafting station. Now, I can give myself an extra floor for my personal, you know, power armor, and we could jump off and attack, but do I want to? Do I need to? Maybe? Maybe not? I can put my power armor overlooking this and drop down there. It doesn't really matter. You know, let's keep it all on the same floor. Not what I normally do, but close enough, or good enough. Power armor crafting station. You need to be somewhere protected while I manipulate my power armor. This is the perfect spot. Awesome. Cool beans. We can park some power armor up here. So all my crafting, all my vendors. There's still other stuff I could put up here if I truly, truly needed to. I could decorate it, but that's functionally what I need. Containers, of course, that's something I always need, so I guess I should just get this done. I like my filing cabinets, what can I say? Filing cabinets are really nice because they don't take up a lot of space and they look very simple, you know? That's why I've used them, people have asked me. I like using them because they're very simple. I can put food there, like weapons and armor in the other one, and that'll be more than enough. And I could actually decorate, but I don't need to right now. Some lighting wouldn't be a bad call, and I have all of the room in the world to work with now that we think about it. So why don't we get some of these lights on the side? Just put you here. And there. Awesome. There. And there. I'll mess around and manipulate conduits as needed. Light here ain't the end of the world. Cool. And the light in the corner is pretty cool, I think. Awesome. I kind of like the idea of putting lights in all the corners like that. That's actually pretty neat. There you go, man. Good shit. So this room would be fairly well lit. There's going to be like a dead spot in the center, but there's not too much I can do about it. Like a corner light. Light here. Skip one. Light here. And skip one. Light there. Alright, and the light like kind of centered up. Good enough. There you go. That gets this pretty well lit. You guys, the vendors, you guys could use some lights, I'm sure. And I'll leave you there. In fact, I'll even bring those up a touch. You, sir, or madam, or whoever ends up going there, will need a light. Alright, now we gotta get some conduits around so they all have power, because Lord knows they don't all have power. Put one here. I can be a little bit generous with the conduits. As long as they connect, I'm good, but yeah, see, that's what I was a little worried about. As long as they connect, I'm happy. Because we have, again, all of the space in the world. All the space in the world. I don't want to go too far. He says as he falls off the damn edge. And it's going to fucking happen. I'm like, where am I? Oh, this is where I am. Rip. Ooh, hey, perfect. It's becoming night. This will make it... Ooh, no. This will make it easy to see everything. So, a conduit there. Just make sure these all link up. Cool. You here. Spacebar, please. And you should be able to connect. Nice. Now, oh god, that's not where I wanted to fall down. These should all be lit, and I need to get lights in like back corner. Cool. As long as all my lights are lit, I'm good. That's what I'm going for. Can you hear? Oh shit, I didn't link this up, did I? Oh, I did, it's just really hard to see. What's the furthest I can get you away? Awesome. So yeah, I said this before, but like the easiest thing to do, the best way to guarantee you get maximum distance is connect them, and then move them after you've connected them, because they'll tell you when you can't go any further, which is pretty cool. And this might well be enough. Come on, a little bit closer. I can't really see it through the wall, but I should be able to do this. Wow, really? That one's not getting power. I am actually a little bit surprised that one's not getting power. Let's add another conduit. I didn't think I'd need one. I mean, look. Right there. Is what it is. Ooh. No. You got power? Hallelujah. These all have power. You have power. A light here wouldn't be the end of the world. I put one, like, there. Nice. Everything here has power. Power. Obviously, that does not have power. That one now has power. The back corner does not have power. I don't even know why half of these have power and half of them don't. This little generator can go too. This was only there to test the sign because I was curious. And now we have our answer because apparently you actually have to connect that, and that is not something I was aware of. Let's do something incredibly silly. Again, probably really silly, but if I link you, I can really pull you far and do this efficiently. Nice. Just daisy chain these bad boys up. Oh, no. Don't store it. I don't need to do anything with that yet. I was gonna say, I don't need to link anything. What's it doing? This is weird. The game's freaking out, man. Fallout freaking out? No. You come over here. I should be able to pull this a little bit more. Yes, sir. every little bit helps, because that means I have less conduits, means I have less failure points. I don't know if these can be broken. My best guess would be probably. I would wager they could fuck your day up if they wanted to. I would hope they don't, but... Motherfucker! God damn it, he picked up the floor and I fell through! It's not the... this is not the object I'm looking for. Yeah, that was not the object I was... that is not the object I was trying to grab. Oh, baby. You, Link, you gotta go. Sorry, ma'am. No need for you. No surprise that that does not connect. Now, I still gotta get power to this back corner. I know that. And this person has light, too. So this should be enough conduits. I think... Oh, I thought I linked it. I think we're good. Just gotta get power back to... Oh, nope. What the hell did I just pick up? I get power back here. You over yonder. Nice. No, don't store things. Stop it. Does everybody have power now? Everybody has power. You have power in the back corner? Back corner? Well, I don't understand why you guys don't have power, but I will attempt to alleviate said issue. I mean, like, it's the back corner. There's power right there. What? Like, the lights are right below me. Like, look right there. There's a light. There's a conduit right here, game. Here. Does that help? No. If I put you closer to the edge, does that help? Apparently that makes a world of difference. I don't know why. But it's a thing. Silly Radstorm. Okay, you now have light. Those are the only two that were missing, yes? Radstorm, not worried about. I just gotta get myself the contamination arch and we'll be good. Good, 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 good. Everybody's got power. Might not be a bad idea to put a light right here. And even right there. So, how do we get power here? Well, shit, now I need more conduits. All the rads that I'm getting. Yay! I love being radiated. It's like my favorite thing ever. Yeah! What he said. Come on. It's a miracle I haven't just fallen over and died. All the dehydration and starvation we've got going on with our character. Do you have power now? Sweet tits. Okay, let's escape. Pop a quick save here. Everybody's got light. Everybody has a crafting station. Or I have. Weak leader. Strong, glad to be rid of him. Savage. Everybody has a crafting station. By that I mean I have my crafting stations. I have all the stores that I really would care about. I have all the defensive value in the world. We have enough food. I could
help fighting them off.
No problem, man. I could assign more to it, and I could also put my water supply down here, which is definitely better defended. Because being out here, a bit of a problem. Now, if I scrap those, do I get anything? See, this is what confuses me. When you put a generator down, you place it down. It doesn't tell you a resource cost. Yet when you scrap it, you get resources. Are you spending resources to create it? I would assume you were, but it doesn't show it. So that's what always is kind of throwing me for a loop. Anyway, water. We want the pump powered because we don't have any other way of getting purified water. Can I please squeeze two of them down here? Please tell me I can. Yep, right there it was. Just get them a little closer. Now, I would love to get my power down here, but there is no graceful way that I'm aware of. I run a conduit down this house, but then there's a conduit that's just exposed and running along the ground. I really wish there was wireless power transmission or the game would simulate some kind of like underground wiring system, you know? Like you could wire just... You could assume that you ran power lines under the ground. Kind of like real world. That'd be neat. But until that day, I gotta make do with what I got. I said that a lot today, but that's basically what Fallout building comes down to, is a whole bunch of compromises. It is sad, but true. As close to this edge as I can, because we'll have to put the other conduit that protrudes out here. So this one. Let's just see how well I can pull this off. Yep, see? I'll bring you up. Okay. Don't break your legs. Good. No legs broken today. That's a start of any good day. Oh, no. It's the start of any good day. This is not DayZ. We're not breaking our legs for no reason. That's totally a meme, but it's totally a true meme. As far down as I can. Nice. So now I can just run power straight down into the little area, but there's going to be a floating power line. Unless I try this. Another conduit. I know we're getting like unnecessarily fancy, but haven't we been doing that this entire time? So let's put you here. Nice. And then I'm doing what I can to keep them off the ground, because they look like butt and they're on their ground. That's just dumb. And I'd like for this building to have a hitbox associated with it. Yes! As a bounding box, I can build on it. Yeah! This is elaborate. We're probably going to have to put a conduit on the ground. There's like nothing I can do about it, but yeah. I could go around the building. I know this is stupid. but bear with me. I'm enjoying this. I enjoy stupidity. Can't you tell? As idiot savant procs. Please let me like place it on the corner. No, game, why? Go here. This is so elaborate. Elaborate ruses are real. Damn, it doesn't go through the wall. I was hoping for some Fallout logic here. What about this? Got snap. Yes, that's exactly what I was hoping for. I mean, it's like the least obtrusive power system I can think of. Like, I'm not walking into a wire and it's all goofy and janky. You need to get stored. How well would one of these work right here? Oh, it'll work, I think. Just gotta be manipulated a bit. Yeah. Yes. The dream! This is like my crowning achievement. Now, please, for the love of God. Like, yeah, I need you to snap here. There. Both of you connected. Why do you not want to, like, snap on any of these surfaces? Don't you deny me of this dream. You will not deny me this dream. This is not happening, game. I mean, like, this is happening. You will not deny me. I did not go through all this effort to get told no. Come on, interact with this. Thank you. Yes! And we have enough power! I did it, guys! Holy shit! It's so stupid! It's so dumb and elaborate and unnecessary. But on the same token, it's so glorious. It's just a whole bunch of con. I mean, I could have put generators down there and wall it off. And we'd never see it again and never have to interact with it. But I'm severely dehydrated. But it's tapped into my main power supply. That's like all I wanted. Shut up. It's tapped into my main power supply. That's what I truly, truly wanted. I love it. Now, these vendors have not found their way up here. I haven't slept, and it's annoying to see that they have not figured out how to pathfind up here yet. They're all just kind of idling about. But it's also possibly due to the fact that they're still bugged because of the settlement attack. We've had this happen before where they just kind of stand there for a while. Until they forget. Like, they're all kind of trying to thank me for helping them, which is really weird. Oh, shit. Well, I guess thanking in some ways not weird, but now I gotta get power into the house if I choose to use. I know I'm severely dehydrated. Like, game, stop. Here.
Thanks for your help. Here's a sip. Fighting them off.
Here's a sip. Look at my AP. Look at my max AP, guys. I know. It's a problem.
He figured out stairs! Oh! He did it!
But guys, it is time to wrap it up here. Episode 432. We're gonna work on some, like, turrets, probably. Maybe, like, just, I don't know. Maybe one in the corner, or one or two kind of sitting here, or three shotgun turrets. So if somebody that's not one of us comes up here, they get lit the fuck up. That's the whole goal. Hi, Strong. You figuring out pathfinding, are you? But that's the whole goal. This is really turning into something that I like. I very much like the way it's turned out. We completely changed the original design, but I think there's respect to be had with a 456 defense base. Still severely dehydrated. Stop making me drink. Game, please. But again, guys, I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up here. Episode 432. Thank you all for watching, and I will now see you next time.
Thanks for your help.